where do you stand on the NFC now that the Saints boat race the Bucks? Seattle got smoked by Buffalo. We did see Tua go toe-to-toe with Kyler Murray. Green Bay did start the week with a win, but it was against a San Francisco B or C team. What are your thoughts right now on the NFC going into the back half of the season?
Well, Saints-Bucks was a staggering game. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. I felt like a lot of the other people. And I remember going into that game, you're trying to pick how it's going to go, and they're both teams are so good and everything. And it occurred to me that one of them was a really good team, and I was worried that one of them was a really good collection of parts. And that turned out to be exactly what it was, with Tampa Bay being the collection of parts. And it's like that game, it felt like if you were to play a seven-game series or even one game, would you rather have the world champion Los Angeles Lakers, the regular roster, or would you rather have the Eastern All-Star team with Giannis and everybody who goes with it? I think you'd rather have the Lakers because they're a real team. They're not a collection of toys. And that's what Tampa Bay looked like to me. The play that killed me that night was that really bad-looking interception on the far side to Antonio Brown, where they were not in the same chapter of the same book, of the same volume, Encyclopedia Britannica. Antonio Brown pulled up short, Brady threw long. And again, I'm kind of thinking, what is he doing out there? They needed him on that team, and I know it was we're gonna take it to the next level, and we're gonna win a Super Bowl with this move, and that's the move. And I don't know. You had really good receivers, and you bring in a really mercurial at best guy, and now it's hurting the football. I have a friend with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, Rich, that I text with sometimes, pretty high up guy, and I remember a couple of weekends ago. When it happened on Saturday night, I think, when they got Antonio and it was happening, I text him, I go, are you guys really bleeping getting Antonio Brown? And all he texted back was a GIF, and it was a GIF of a poker player pushing a giant stack of chips right to the middle of the table. Mm-hmm. And listen, it's a huge gamble, and I did not like what I saw. Never mind the off-the-field stuff, which is unsavory to say the lightest. The on-field was off, too. And if Brady's going to sit there and force it to the guy who stays in his house all the time, I don't know. Throw it to Evans and Godwin. It was a really weird night. And that leaves me in a long-winded way to answer your question. I guess the Saints right now are the truth. Just the team that we don't know if we can trust in the playoffs. So everybody buckle up.
Yeah, I know. And Seattle's defense is on pace, to use the sports phrase, of some pretty unprecedentedly bad numbers. And we saw the Bills slice them up. Now we'll see what happens with the Rams coming off of the bye week. And, you know, I just don't want to sleep on Green Bay. I just don't want to sleep on them because, again, just because there's only three players on their team that fantasy owners have does not mean they're not a Super Bowl contender. You know, you're going to throw Robert, don't call me Tanyan.
It's the greatest compliment. I mean,
seriously.
To those guys. Be like, You know, I'm looking at your team, and you're wildly flawed. I don't mean just the baseball card has a little bit of the corner that's pulled back. Like the thing is messed up. It's not even close to a perfect team.
Right.
But it still feels like a Onus Wagner, like Aaron Rodgers. It still feels that good. Heavily flawed team. I look at them. I think we're inevitably going to see, Rich, for the ninth time in their careers, Russell Wilson versus Aaron Rodgers, because both. I feel like they're the same team. Prolific quarterbacks, wildly flawed teams that I don't think are good enough to win a Super Bowl, but are going to run into each other for the ninth time, and they're 4-4, and the home team always wins. So I love those teams too, but as in the same breath that you say, I love Green Bay, and I do too, I didn't even recognize them against Tampa, who I didn't even recognize against New Orleans. The snake is eating its tail.
I know. It's Saints beat Bucks, who beat Packers, and it just goes on and on and on.
And they were in the movie with Kevin Bacon. It's
yes,
crazy.
They were, in fact, just a couple of steps removed from Flash, from all sorts
Footloose.
Footloose and all that stuff. Yeah. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.